About a month after he died, well, I decided we're going to Florida, me and two of my kids. We get in the car on the morning of the worst snowstorm that we had had all winter. Like, this just goes to show you that you really shouldn't make any big decisions after somebody dies because you're not thinking right. And I kept driving. And, you know, when I think about it now, I think, were you crazy? You're taking your life and your children's life in your hands. And if it was that bad, why didn't you take a plane? I don't know. I think that when I went to Florida, I thought that I was going to go there and this was going to go away. But when I got there, I realized that this isn't going away because I brought it here with me. But it's almost like a thing that you're trying to, I don't know, you're trying to run away from it. You think that if you put yourself in a different geographical position that, you know, it's going to be, but it's not. But I think that's how, you know, your mind screws around with you. It really does. Because it's, how do I not feel this pain? But the pain is there. It doesn't matter where you go with it, you know? So after you've gone through something horrible, don't make any really crazy decisions. Like even why they say, you know, people should never move or, you know, decide to, relocate or make big, work decisions right after a death because you're not thinking straight and you're not, you know, truly. Because when I look back on that, I think I must have been crazy. There was no other car on the road. Just us and the snowplows.
Pushing your way down.
Yeah, you know, and that day didn't even dawn on me. I'm just going, you're driving, you know, you just be careful. But when I thought of it later, I thought, Jesus, Murphy, you were really crazy. Yeah. But I guess you are. You know, you are a little crazy after someone that you love. You know, and I think even more so a spouse. Because a parent, when they're old, you almost, you know, it's like you expect them to die before you. But I think when somebody loses someone very young, and I think, you know, my husband at least had a decent life. You know, there's people who die much younger. It does. It's hard to reconcile that in your head. It's, you know, it's just a really difficult thing.